What's up guys, Johnny here, back with more Shadowgun Legends. Today, my brand new updated Blade Dancer guide. It's been requested a lot. It's gonna be a full run and I will show everything step by step. So let's go. When you exit the ship, you're gonna go right and up to the hill battle that we call. It's where the voidcaller is. So you can ignore everything until the voidcaller, but then you kill everything. So kill the elites, of course. They are the most dangerous enemies, the yellow ones. So kill most of the stuff or pretty much everything, and you see that container there? As you kill stuff, it's gonna open. This is where you need to go, but you need to kill stuff to get it open. So keep killing as a squad, work together. AM bomb's really good. There you go, container is open there. You can skip that shielder here, but you can kill it if you want. It's gonna be easier if you don't kill it. So now we're gonna move and get to this big door where there are three spots to place charges. There are crushers defending that door, so you're gonna have to kill these crushers, of course. And now you need to find three charges. So one is right here on the right of the door. There's a little tunnel here. So go through that tunnel and you will find one of the charges. So usually when you work as a team and you guys all know the dungeon, you will split. Every player is gonna go get his own charge. So it's important that before you go for the run, you decide who goes where, okay? So we got the first charge. We're gonna go back to the big door and place this charge on one of the spots. Okay. So then the other charges, there are more than three, by the way. I think there's five total. But what I do usually, you don't have to kill anything. What I usually do is I run past everything and I will go straight to the door over there. When you open this door, it will open a container where the void caller was at the start. All right, so that was the hill fight when we fought the void callers. This container was closed at the start, but when I opened the door, it opened now. So there was a charge here. We're gonna go place that charge. So Super Kush got it. He's gonna place it. And usually the third charge that I take is on my way back. Because usually what I do, I go run straight past everything. I go open the door. And then on my way back, I will claim that charge right here that's sitting on the crate. So if you work together, this part is really fast because one guy stayed at the container near the void caller and the other two guys would go alone and fight everything. So once the three charges are placed, there's a detonation, then it opens the new area. All right, now, this you can pretty much ignore right now, but this is gonna be where you're gonna go soon. So you got a closed area here with a force field. You got lasers here. So the door you have to open is this one now, the one on your left. So we can kill everything. There's a void caller, there's two gray enemies. And when you kill the two gray enemies, it opens the door on the far left. So that door here, there will be a switch. That switch will kill the force field that you saw on the right. So go back. And you see over there, the force field is no longer there. So you have access to that utility room. The lasers are still there. To open the lasers, you have to go behind this door and hide two consoles. This door is locked. You can go here and click that switch. You'll have a limited time to get to the security room. You see the floor is now blue. That opens this, and you have two elites here usually and a red box. The red box, if you kill it, it will open the door. So you might want to leave it closed while you're hacking because there might be some enemies. Anyways, you have to hack the two consoles now. So once you're done hacking the two consoles, the lasers go down and you now have access to this part of the dungeon. So There's an elevator here. You can pretty much ignore it. There's lasers. This is where you need to go for the teleporter room. And then there's the left part where there's some gas. So we're gonna go here and kill the lasers. So first door on the right. There's a gravity lift. It's gonna take you up. And there's a control room. So here, kill everything. All right. So once you kill everything, there's a console. There's a thing here with a number 3. And there's a switch here. This switch will kill the lasers downstairs. And this right here is the console. You want to activate it. Press it only once. So now you need a security code. You need 4 codes that you're going to have to find around the map. So 1, 2, 3, 4. They are not the right codes, by the way. But once you click that, this here is going to be your code number 3. And as soon as someone on your team, anyone finds any code, it will be on your heads up display for the whole team. So if someone else finds a code, you will also see it. And on the other side of that window, you'll see where you have to put the codes later. All right. And don't forget to open this door. It helps when you want to go through later if you need to. All right, let's go back down. And before we go on the laser area, we're going to go fetch the code number 1. It's right on your right. So as you exit, instead of going left, take a right. And right here is going to be your code number 1. You have to hack here. Right, once you're done hacking, it will display code number 1, and you see on my heads up display, now I have 1 and 3, all we need is 2 and 4 now. We're gonna go back all the way, past the elevator, and then take a left here, and behind this door is a teleporter room. So first time here, we're gonna go on the right teleporter. I think this is teleporter A and the other one's teleporter B. All right, so there will be a door here. We need to go here. There's a crusher behind. So kill stuff. Kill the crusher. And kill the red box here. It will open the door. See, the door is now open. We're gonna go back. Hack. So this is the elevator. Elevator is now working. Well, let's go up. Once you're up, kill everything again. Especially that crusher. And now hack this console. So radar door controls activated. It will give you access to this area now. Now you have access. This is to change teleporter B. You need to do that. I'll show you in a second. But teleporter B is now reconfigured. So next time you go in the teleporter room, the left teleporter will now bring you to one of the codes that you need. So we now have unlocked the whole area. This is the radar room. So this is where we configured teleporter B. This is where we're gonna have to input our codes. And if you go left, it's where we were a minute ago. It's the console room, okay? So now we're gonna go fetch code 2 and 4. I'm gonna go back to the gravity lift. But again, when you play as a team, one player goes and fetch all the codes while the other two players start changing the codes in the radar room. So again, teleporter room. Teleporter B is now reconfigured, so we're gonna go teleporter B. And this is our code number 4. See, it just popped up on my display. We have 1, 3, 4. And this is gonna reconfigure teleporter A. Teleporter A now configured. This is gonna bring me back to where I was, where there's a crusher and elevator. And this is gonna bring me back to the teleporter room. So here we go. Teleporter B, teleporter A. Now that teleporter A is reconfigured, we're gonna go there. It's gonna bring me to code number 2. Here we go. So as you see, this code is changing all the time. You need to kill the red switch right over here. And now it's gonna stop moving. We have all four codes now. So let's go and put the codes in the radar room. So to go back, there's a lot of ways you can go, but we're gonna go through the gravity lift. You could have gone the elevator way if you wanted to. So let's go. We're gonna kill these guys. Radar room. So there's numbers here. We have code number one. We need to put an S. So we're gonna click, watch the code, click again. And there's the S, okay? Now right here is number three. Number three is like an underscore with two dots. There you go. Right here is number four. Four is like two long bars with a dot. There you go. And the last one is number two right here. It's an upside down L. There you go. So the whole code is now supposed to be correct. If we didn't make any mistake, we should be good. So we're gonna go back at the control room and click the console to confirm the code.
Hey, glad it's still working.
And it says combination approved. So we're gonna be teleported to the boss fight now. It's gonna be the Blade Dancer boss. It's one of the toughest bosses in the game. And we're gonna work as a team. We didn't die yet, but we might start dying now because this boss is a real tough one. All right, so we're all in a pod. The boss will spawn in the middle. So we're gonna go supercharger and everything and start shooting the boss in the back as much as possible because he takes more damage in the back and in the head. While he's spinning, he's also taking some damage, so. A good way to do it is one of your teammates will kite the Blade Dancer, like draw aggro, and the other two guys would shoot him in the back. He's dead. So that's it. Hope you enjoyed the guide. If you did, leave a like. And don't forget to watch my other videos. I will link a speedrunning guide. If you know the dungeon and you want to do it fast, make sure you watch my other guides. Thanks for watching. See you guys soon.